Hello, hola, bonjour. Oh, 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 oh. Hello, hello, hola, bonjour. Bawani. Words in different languages that mean different things, different things, different things. Hello, everybody. Welcome to Ninja Inspiration. Today it's gonna be an amazing video because I'm gonna be speaking about words. Words. See how excited I get. I mean, I'm speaking about words, I'm so excited. So I'm gonna be telling you guys words that are the same in different languages but mean something completely different. And some things might even be odd, but anyways, let's get started. So I'm gonna start with German, also ich rede mit Deutsch anfangen. Und ja, wir werden sehen, was ein Wort bedeutet auf Deutsch und was es auf Englisch bedeutet. So we're gonna see different words, what they mean in German and what they mean in English, and they're quite different. Number one would be the word bad. So bad in English is of course the contrary of good, but in German it means toilet, bathroom, yeah. Number two, we have the word hell. So hell, with this pronunciation, hell, would be in German something that is bright, that is light. So you can say, mein Zimmer ist hell. So, which is like, my room is bright, not that your room is a hell. Number three, the word Kind. In English, Kind would be kind, so it's written the same way. In German, Kind is a child, and in English, kind is to be kind. Number four, the word Boot. So Boot in English is a boot, like what you wear. In German, it would mean a boat, so it's quite different. Number five would be the word gift. So a gift in German would be a poison, and in English a gift is a gift. So you can say, I'm gonna give you a gift, and in German that would mean I'm gonna give you a poison, so be careful with what you say. Number six would be the word angel in English, but in German Engel, and Engel would be like a vision rod, so it's quite different. Number seven would be the word elf. So elf in English is an elf, so this mythology kind of supernatural creature. In German, elf is number 11. So 10 and 1. 11. So yeah, it's quite different. And the last one, and my favorite, because this is when I went to Germany. I was doing my Erasmus in Cologne, and I would go through the town hall, and you would see, like when you go, you will see it written like Rathaus, so that would be like a rat house. So at the beginning, when my German wasn't that good, I was like, is this the house of rats, or what is it, what exactly is this? And I found out that it's actually the town hall, and it's interesting, but it's quite funny that the word rat kind of comes from, or I guess it comes from Ratten, which is like to advise. So I'm guessing town hall, like the advice or house, it makes sense, but be careful, don't think Rathaus would be the rat house, okay? Ich habe gerade gesagt, da ist war so lustig für mich, als ich in Köln war, als ich mein Erasmus machte, dass also ein Rathaus, das Rathaus, also alle kennen, was ein Rathaus ist, aber für mich auf Englisch Rathaus bedeutet wie ein, also das Tier, und das war ein bisschen komisch für mich, aber es war gut. I'll be moving on to words that are written the same way in English and in French, but mean numéro un. The word sale. So in English, sale is like something you sell, like a sale. Mais en français, but in French, sale means dirty. So be careful. The word is written the same way, but of course the pronunciation is quite different. Number two, coin. A coin, you know, it's the currency, it's a coin. But in French, with French, c'est cher. And that would be like, you know, skin. You can say cher or beau, which would be skin. Number four, retard. Not a good word in English. In French, retard. And that would be like, you're running late. So I could say, oh, désolé, j'arrive en retard. And it's not that I'm a retard, but I'm you know, I'm getting late. Five, the word fart. Yeah, that's not a good word to use in English. If you want to be a lady, yeah, fart now. But in French, it would mean a pet. And that's a really cute thing, a pet. So a pet would be fart, the fart, in French. And now number six, I guess. Yeah, number six would be pain. We say pain, but in English would be pain. So the word is written the same way, pain. When you have pain, it's a pain. But in French, you would say pain, and that's your bread. Number seven, four. Four is a number, yeah, but in French four, it's not four, would be four, and the four would be the oven. Pretty different, huh? But really interesting. The next one would be pie. Yeah, but pie would be pied, which would be your foot, which is quite different. So be careful with pie and pied. Of course, the pronunciation is always different in French, but the way you write them, actually, the one I really like is the word car, of course, car in English, but in French it would be car. Car would mean because. So I did something, car, blah, 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 because, which is quite different. I don't know why this word is so different, because the meaning have nothing to do. I don't know what the etymology are, but really different, huh? Really interesting. Now I'm just gonna say words I have found in different languages that are completely different in English, but of course they're written the same way, but they mean something totally different. So for example, en español, in Spanish we say pie, like, you know, like in French, and it also means foot. We also say pan, and pan would be bread, and in French pan could be like a saucepan. We also say sin. Sin would be without, but sin in English means sin, you know, you're a sinner or something. And in Catalan we say cap. Cap would be your head, but a cap in English is like a cap. But I think it's quite funny because it actually has a relation, so they're not totally, you know, senseless and different. But of course, a cap is a cap and a head is a head, but it's quite similar, you know. And the one we also say in Catalan would be any, so any would be the year, but in English is any. So the pronunciation is different, but the written form is the same. And the one I really find interesting, and I kind of have like an anecdote about this, is the word once. Once in Spanish, which would be written in English as once, so O-N-C-E. And for example, I think there was a movie called You Only Fall in Love Once, I think, and when they translated this movie into Spanish, they called it Solo Te Enamoras Once. So it's kind of meant like you only fall in love 11, like, do you ever fall in love 11 times? I don't think so. So they left the translate the original version, so once in English, but then they translated the sentence, you only fall in love, and that kind of like created some confusion. But anyways, you know, things happen, you know, we're translators, things happen. Another one that I found interesting in I think in Slovak and Russian they say brat, and brat means brother. So if you've been calling your brother a brat, don't worry, you know, if you learn Ukrainian or Russian, you're pretty right, you're calling him your brother, but don't do that. Don't call your brother a brat, okay? Another one I wanted to mention is the word arm, which in Dutch and actually in German mean to be poor, but of course in English it's to be poor, but in German and in Dutch it's the arm. So arm, which is actually the same pronunciation, would be to be poor. The next one would be in Scandinavian languages, which I think is really interesting, is the word fart. Again, like I said before, in French, fart in Scandinavian languages, or mostly, I think, yeah, most of them, so Norwegian, Danish, I think, mean speed. So if you say something like fart, whatever, control, so speed control, and that would be, you know, fart control in English, which could be funny. The last one would be the funniest one, I think, for me. It would be the word preservative in English, so something you use to preserve food, so the food or your jam or your jelly, you know, won't get spoiled. But don't say that in Spanish, okay, or in French, preservative or preservativo. Don't say that in Spanish or French. I'm not gonna tell you guys what it means. I think you can go on Google and search that yourself, but it means something. Thank you very much for watching this video. I hope you really enjoyed it. You know, I'm a language fan. I love words. I love languages. I like flamenco. I don't know why people are saying this, but anyways, I love words. I like words. I like languages. I love, you know, this false friends and things like that. And I hope you really enjoyed this video and you've learned some things. And when you're learning a new language, just be careful with these false friends. And not really false friends, but like this, the words you write the same way but mean completely different things. But of course, I guess with the context and the, you know, when you have a higher level in the languages, you get to know the meaning and you don't make these mistakes, but they can be quite funny. Thank you for watching the video. Give it a thumbs up, please, a like, and subscribe to my channel, okay? Hit the subscribe button. It's down below. It's the color red thing which says subscribe. So, por favor, suscribiros a mi página. Ahí abajo veis lo que pone subscribe en inglés y darle. Así podéis ver mis nuevos videos. Gracias por vuestro tiempo. Je vous remercie pour votre temps. Et s'il vous plaît, donnez subscribe à mes pages de YouTube. Comme ça, vous aurez des nouvelles sur les nouveaux vidéos que je ferai. Merci beaucoup et on se voit en. Wir sehen uns in. Wir sehen wir auf. Ninja.